Hey, gun people. Figured I'd do Buddy's feet. I gotta have this camera back here. I need to shadow the wind. I'll pick it up, blow it out here. So, I don't know how much you can be able to see. But I gotta turn his feet. Since his last trimming, and part of that is because I let him go a little too long. He's pooping again, so I gotta clean up his poop again. I don't want him standing in it while I'm cleaning his feet. I know, you're a good boy. I know, stand up, clean it up. This around on the grass around the trees. I try not to get it too strong on the trees because it'll get right in that seat. try and show you that chip on that front hoof there, what it looks like before and what it looks like after I get done with it. And again, I don't think chips are the end of the world. This one looks pretty bad. And then on the back hoof, everybody's asking about that little hole. Where's it at? Oh, I'm still on his front feet. Where's his back foot? There's his hole. So that's the hole that's growing out. I do not think that was a blowout. I still think he kicked something that punctured that hoof wall. I know a lot of experts were telling me I was wrong, didn't know what I was talking about, but, and I could be wrong, but I'm gonna go ahead and see if that'll stay in light there. And I'm just gonna trim down this hoof a little bit. Get that off. Videos. This is just a hoof pick that I'm cleaning out. Now I'm gonna go ahead and trim off some of this heel. It isn't really that bad. It's just got that was a bad flare. And I should have sprayed it down with fly spray before I started. That'll help keep them less messing with the flies. Right on the toe, boy. I don't know why. Let me know. Hey, you good boy. Hey, you good little buddy, boy. Come on up. I usually don't use it. I should move that camera around. I'll put his foot down and move that camera around. As soon as I move the camera, he ends up moving and he's out of camera view. So let's put this camera so you can kind of tell what I'm doing. Because I didn't get my damn gloves on. I already cut my damn hand. I'm bleeding. Can you show blood on YouTube? Ooh, I'll just censor that out. It's okay. All right. So, good. All right. So his sole, since I don't take off a lot of sole, I could really peel this down a lot. And I just let it wear out naturally in pasture. Oh shit, that scared me. I thought I heard a gunshot. Didn't scare buddy. So if it looks like the wall's a little lower, it is. And I'm just gonna put an angle on that wall. So that means I have to use my grasp less. Spray because he's up. So I get it. Move my broom before he breaks this. I Alright, so which hoof was I on? Let's try this again. I'm gonna tie him up short. Otherwise he likes to dance around. Well, you didn't have to be tied up short, but you kept dancing around. So now you are.
I know. I'll move this back here.
Move his butt around where it's straight. Move this way, boy. One more step. Go on. Good boy. I know. Back up. One more. Alright. Good boy.
Here.
Good boy, he's standing still. Rick, you were mean to him, and that wasn't...
Be quiet, big dummies.
Good boy. I know. So this will... And he really didn't have a lot of stuff to take off. It was only taken off this much. But because he's flared out, it's putting pressure on the outside of those walls, so I'm gonna narrow them up. And try to remove that flare. And if you ain't never cut yourself with a rasp, it freaking hurts. All right, so that one's done. I'll do the top part on him. Back one. Move the camera, see what a back one looks like. The wind's died down, so it's not too bad right now. I know. He's not in trouble anymore. As long as he stands still, he doesn't get in trouble. But he's only a bad boy and gets in trouble when he moves around because he knows he shouldn't. I know. I usually keep my knee in here so he doesn't pull his foot forward. Tell he stepped in a poop. That's why you clean up your poop. See, he doesn't really have much of a wall. He's got a little bit of heel, and he's flaring out right here. So I'm going to take that down. And again, a lot of people would say you should take some sole off. I don't really mess with the sole. I let the pasture and him roaming around do that. So you can tell I'm not really taking off a whole bunch. Except for this flare area right here. See, when people say that you're being mean to a horse and he doesn't know what you're talking about, you notice he's not moving once I kind of said, hey, stop messing around with me. Good boy. And this is going to level off that sole. And now I'm going to shrink this down. See how thick it is? Hey, hey, quit pulling. We'll set that down. That one's done except for the top. I know. We'll let you adjust a little bit. You just don't be jumping around and moving all the time. So I just did my 4th of July video, ride him a little bit. And I'm probably sweating more than he is. Ho, stand.
You're going to get in big trouble again.
Damn. Ho. Come. Back. Come. Back. One more hoof to do. Come on, buddy, you can do it. Stand. Nope. Knock it off. Okay, so let's see, buddy. We'll get a little lunging in here. Because buddy doesn't know how to stand still. Sometimes it's easier. Hey. Sometimes it's easier. See, he started to pay attention to Mr. T and not me. He kind of crowded me and said, hey, I don't have to listen to you. I want to go to Mr. T. So he got a little bit of a. If he wants to move his feet, I'm going to move his feet. Play a fight with him. I'll make it to where he doesn't want to move his feet. If he thinks moving his feet is the right answer, it is. Now, because I'm telling him. And I'll change direction that uses big horse muscle. Okay. Does it look like he's off balance because I didn't do that last rear shoe? I didn't tell you to stop. Come on. So I didn't do that last rear shoe. Hey, keep going. Something that I can't control, and he ends up bucking and kicking and biting, and it progresses. So at the first little signs of kind of like, I don't have to listen to you, we need to work out, we need to reestablish that I'm in charge, I get to control your feet, I can control when you run and when you stop, it's easier to stand still than it is to move. And that's basically what I'm doing. So now I'm going to ask him nicely to walk off, he doesn't have to trot. See if he listens. Responsive. I know he can be a good horsey. He can also be a bad horsey. If nobody makes him be a good horsey. I know. Come on. Yeah, it's a big meeting. Yeah, it's mean to buddy boy. Alright, let's see if he'll let me finish this last hoof now. Notice I'm not pulling him anywhere. I hate to see people pulling horses. And of course, it's not all his fault. I keep getting behind him and I'm trying to film and I'm talking, which means I'm not paying 100% attention to him. I'm right in there and move it. Got one damn foot, and it's taken more than it did to do all the three other feet, because you don't want to listen to the foot. I know. So this one doesn't look like it's too dirty. Wet. So that's the bad thing about doing his feet when I'm separating him from Mr. T. I took him for a ride and he got nervous. There's a little hoof wall here, not a lot. A little piece of thing just hanging right there I'm going to clip off. So I'm using these nippers to take a little bit of sole off. Back feet aren't as important as front feet because horse carries most of his weight on the front feet. So it's usually better to do the front feet first. So if there's problems or issues, you got the important stuff done. Now I could let him out in pasture right now and it wouldn't hurt anything. He's just running around messing with Mr. T. Put a little edge off here because it's kind of thick, and I'm going to round that off with my rasp. That looks pretty good. Good boy. All right. I'm going to move this over here. Of course, Mr. T, he being a good old boy, antagonizing buddy. Saying, look at me, I'm free. Come on out here. You can be free too. That's why Buddy's getting in trouble. Wind's picking up, so you may not be able to hear me. But if you want to watch, you can watch. If you don't, well, that's okay too. All over the place for the thing that's in my damn hand. Now I'm looking for the rasp. Alright, let's see if I... pull that out just a little bit. You can tell it's not really round there, so I'm just gonna angle this. Here's where he was flaring out. So I normally don't bend the hoof wall, but I want to stop this flare because the hoof is growing out like this. So if I make it level, it'll grow more like that. Put my little beveled edge on it. Because it's hot out here, the wind's blowing, I'm not doing a great job. What I'll do is a couple days from now I'll come back and I'll just take a rasp and that out in the field. I'll put the hoof up and round it up or do anything that I want to if I don't think it's wearing properly. So that's that one done. Now I got to do remove that chip. Hopefully it will be in camera. Good boy. Dad likes it when you're a good boy. Big flare right here. It's rolling out like that. I'm gonna thin that wall out a little bit. And by angling this inward, the hoof wall is gonna grow weak at a point, and it'll take a while for the top part to get down there. Out there, take long strokes once I get started. And if I had gloves on, now I'm using a smooth sided rasp so it doesn't catch as much. But I wanted to show you that got rid of that chip. Of course, he moves it. Damn horse knows, just trying to piss me off. So that's where the chip was. And I'm seeing a lot of people coming here telling me I'm taking too much off the wall, I'm coming too high. Look, my horse has never gone lame, and I've always done my feet this way. And, you know, it works for me. So, but since I didn't do my little finishing stone here. Come on. You moved back, didn't you? And this just makes it really smooth and takes off rough edges. More aesthetically, I think it strengthens it a little bit. Makes that round beveled edge, which gives it more strength. I don't know the scientific term, but I know it works. Call it the Mustang roll. Alrighty. Put a fresh battery in here. I'm pretty sure it's still good. I should probably check it. All right, still good. So now I'll do the tops of these guys. Hanging on to my buddy, my little buddy. He's a good horsey boy. He's a good little horsey boy. Ain't nothing like swinging my horse around. Alright, let's get this back foot up. Man, you can tell where it gets really sharp there. And I talk about pulling. Pulling is kind of making this part right here on the hoof a little higher so the hoof can flex. So you want to get this pulling right in here. And that's normally where a horse will get his first chips. I've got a picture on my website. And a lot of people will round that back hoof. Sometimes I'll make a little flat mark because I know they drag that hoof. So I make a little bitty flat mark right on the front. Not that big of a deal. That should grow out a couple months. If you remember, it was probably about up here. And it's grown out. And because I didn't do my little white thing, rounding stone. I know Dad's messing up. He should be keeping this on his stand. Switch legs. Good boy. Now, I don't know if you guys can tell the difference. I know I can definitely feel the difference. It's just as smooth as glass. Oh, good boy. All right, buddy, one more. Woo-hoo! I'm telling you, this is the... I need to hire a farrier because I just... I mean, I hate having someone else do my horse's feet, but this just freaking wears me out, man. It's probably 89 out here in the shade. Probably heat index is 90. I think they said it's supposed to get 92 today. It'll feel like 98 in the shade. It looks like he's getting another little crack on this hoof. Notice that little... And again, somebody's going to say that's an abscess. To me, it looks like he hit something. He kicked it. He did something. Again, I'm not going to worry about it. It's going to grow out. It's angled, so it's not really full. You'll be able to tell when I get it up on that hoof stand over there. Let me move my hoof stand where it's supposed to be. And now maybe I can zoom in on it. And hopefully Buddy won't move it. Get in trouble. I'm already going to get yelled at by viewers because I corrected him.
Poor Buddy! His dad's mean to him! His dad is mean to him! Because he's such a good boy, he never does anything wrong!
Pissing himself off now. I know. He keeps forgetting his damn little finishing stone, buddy.
I know, he's a good boy. I know, horse.
Dad loves him when he's a good boy. When he's a bad boy, he gets in trouble. Like bad boys do.
I know you guys are thinking that He's happy I'm finished, but I guarantee you, he ain't as happy as I am. So I'm just gonna brush him down just a little bit, get his sweat marks off. God, he don't care. Mr. T corrects him all the time. And they're best buds. Because horses like to know where they stand. Just like children. You don't know the rules, and you're always changing the rules. You just threaten there is no rules, or you arbitrarily enforce the rules. It confuses kids. It confuses adults. And it confuses horses. So, instead of worrying about being your kid or your horse's friend, worrying about being a good leader and good example, and make them the best they can be, do things for their own good, instead of your sensitive rice paper ego. I want my horse to love me. I can't be mean to him. If I'm mean to him, he won't love me. He'll run away. Meanwhile, you still can't catch the damn horse. You're telling everybody he loves you. Rick, why are you picking on stupid women? Shut up, you big dummies. It's the 4th of July. I can pick on who I want.
Oh, please don't be mad at Dad. He's going to have nightmares because Dad was so mean to him. I know. Dad was so mean to him. He's going to have big mean nightmares. I know. Poor buddy! He's mad at his dad!
Alright, so watch Mr. T's. He's walking, watch Mr. T turn around. He's like, oh, he's gonna get some grain. I better start moseying over there in case the grain comes out. Alright.
I'm coming. Don't you be impatient to be coming at gate. Me trying to stop Buddy from being a bully,
it's just better if I leave it alone and let Mr. T do it. When I try to help, I end up screwing it up. So when I left, they figured it out. When I was standing there trying to make Buddy move and getting mad at Buddy for blocking out Mr. T and being a jerk, Mr. T read that on me and went, oh shit, he's either pissed at Buddy or he's gonna try and catch me. I'm getting out of here. So all right, that's doing their feet. Good 4th of July. I'm going to post my 4th of July video, but in case y'all missed that one, happy 4th. Horses, guns, I had the American flag out here. Well, then out there, happy birthday, America! Some of us still love you, not those crazy left-wing idiots.